NGA. We're gonna learn it from NGA. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from Angie.
That's me. Welcome to Engineering Expo. Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go.
Hi, I'm Rachel, and I'm an engineer at Future Foam. I'm also part of the Engineering Expo Committee, and we have a special guest today, Roy.
Hi, I'm Roy Moy III, a design engineer at Spirit Aerosystems, and your fellow singing engineer from STEM Music. Today we have a really cool activity. We're gonna do the self-inflating balloon activity, and here are the materials you will need. Alright, so now that you know the materials for this experiment, let's get to it, right?
Yes.
So today we are going to learn about a chemical reaction. It's going to be really, really cool. But we're going to need two things. What we mentioned in the material list, vinegar and baking soda. And guess what? Vinegar is an acid and baking soda is a base. Now, if we kind of like use this vinegar and maybe took a sip of it or smelled it, it probably wouldn't be the best, right? Sour, acetic. But then with this baking soda, if we took a taste of that, it'd probably be very bitter and like have us going, nah, 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 not the greatest thing, right? So in my mind, I'm saying, are there other acids and bases that you might know about, Rachel?
Yeah, so I think lemon juice and tomato sauce are both acids. And when I think of a base, I think of milk.
Exactly. So when an acid and a base come together, usually there's like a crazy thing that occurs. And today, that's our chemical reaction that we need. And so when we combine vinegar and baking soda, we create a gas. And that gas is carbon dioxide. Now, you might be thinking, hey, Roy, what is carbon dioxide? Well, I think we can show them better than we can tell them. So can we just take a deep breath in and breathe out all together? Here we go. 1, 2, 3. That felt really good, Rachel. Can we do it one more time?
Yes.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3. If you just breathed out with us, you breathed out carbon dioxide. So that's the gas that we're going to produce in this experiment. So before we get started, there's one important thing that we need to remember. And what is that thing?
Safety.
Safety first. Now let's jump into this experiment. The first thing that you're gonna need is your bottle with a half cup of vinegar in it. It should be in your kit, but even if it's not, you can just use an empty water bottle and then use a funnel to pour your half cup of vinegar into your bottle, and it'll be great, all right? Now, the next thing we're gonna use is what?
Well, if we've already used the vinegar, I believe this would be the next thing we use.
Baking soda, exactly. Rachel has it down. So we're gonna use this baking soda, but guess what? We need to put this baking soda inside our tiny little balloon. We can stretch it out and make sure it's flexible, but how are we gonna do that, Rachel?
Well, I imagine if we already use the funnel to put the liquid in here, then we can also use it to put the baking soda in the balloon.
Exactly, Rachel is correct. So you can use your same funnel that you use for the vinegar to put your baking soda inside the balloon. So we're gonna attach it on just like this, just kind of put it over the mouth of that smaller side of the funnel, and then we're going to get our scoop, our teaspoon of baking soda. You can be generous with it, which means it doesn't have to be exact. And then you just pour that right in there, tap the edge a little bit just to make sure it's all in there. I like to tap the side too sometimes. And then pull this off, and I'll hand it to Rachel as she does hers. And then you should be able to kind of pinch down at the bottom and feel all of the baking soda settled at the bottom of this balloon. And then we'll tell you the next step once Rachel is done with hers. Notice how she tapped the side to make sure all of it's falling into the balloon. So, you ready for the next step?
I am ready.
All right, so our next step is we're going to fasten this balloon onto the top of our water bottle that has vinegar in it. All right, so here we go. You just kind of stretch it over the mouth. And then I always like to kind of wiggle it into place to make sure it's centered over the mouth of our water bottle that has our half cup of vinegar in it. Now, when we get ready to do this, we're gonna do a countdown.
Okay.
Why do we do a countdown? It just makes things better, right? It's more fun. So we're gonna start from 5 and go down to 1, and then we're gonna lift this up and pour that baking soda in and see what happens. Are you ready?
I am ready.
Let's do it in 5, 4, 3, two, one. Lift it up and twist, 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 twist. We got a reaction. Let's go. You see the bubbles? Carbon dioxide gas being created, and look at our balloons being blown up.
Wait, so what just happened?
That's a great question, Rachel. So we had a chemical reaction when we combined vinegar and baking soda, and it blew up our balloons.
Yeah.
Pretty cool. Now, check this out. You can also experiment further by adding more baking soda inside your balloon or vinegar inside your bottle and see how that reaction occurs when you do that. Also, you can add some food coloring to see this experiment in color. It'd be really, really cool to see that. Now, as I'm thinking about it, Rachel, I think there are some other experiments you can do with baking soda and vinegar. Can you think of some of those?
Well, I believe there is a volcano experiment and a little mini rocket ship experiment. They use the same chemical reaction.
That is so cool. So you at home can do those experiments, check them out, see if they work, and see how they react. Now, we do have some questions for you, right?
Yes.
So be sure to use your engineering notebook. Get it out and get ready for these questions. I think I have a question, and Rachel, you have one?
I do.
All right, so here's my question. What was produced when we combined vinegar and baking soda to blow up our balloon?
We used vinegar and baking soda. Which one's the acid and which one's the base?
Thank you so much for joining us today. I'm so glad you got to do that experiment with us.
Take a video of your experiment and upload it to our event page, and you could win a prize.
That's right. And be sure to like and subscribe, and stay tuned right after this for a special STEM music performance.
Until then,
see you next time. Are you ready for the STEM music concert? Here we go. STEM music, it's a movement. STEM music, oh, let's do it. Everywhere we go, we call it STEM music. People gotta know, we call it STEM music. We gon' make it flow, we call it STEM music. We call it STEM music, we call it STEM music. Said everywhere we go, we call it STEM music. People gotta know, we call it STEM music. And we gon' make it flow, we call it STEM music. All right, let's call it STEM. And so much to see. It's time that we uncover opportunity. So many different careers, from scientists to engineers, mathematicians.
We call it STEM music. Now let's jump into the science song. I'm so glad you did that activity with us. It was fun. We blew up a balloon. So let's celebrate it by singing about science. Here we go. Clap it up. Science is gonna lead the way. It will reveal what we've never known before. Like maybe a brand new element or a species that we haven't met. Exploration at its finest. Yeah, that's for sure. With science, we'll try it. With science, we'll find it. With science, we'll journey past the stars and more.
You probably couldn't see me. Hold on.
She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from NG.
Angie.
That's me. Thanks for joining us today. See you next time.